The rhinoceros beetle was first reported to cause damage on coconut palms in 1889. Since then, it has widely spread and is now found in over 37 countries in Asia, Africa, and the Pacific, decreasing the farmer's income and affecting his livelihood and family.
Siya, problema, Brad.
Ayaw problema, Brad. Pagpiling bakukang. Dawat ba?
Ano, dako ba yung kadawat ang bakukang sa itong panginaboy?
Oo, dako kayo ang epekto. Kaya niya itong 2003, utaga ko 8,000 kalektarya. Apan, karong 2006, 4,000 na lang. Unsa kay katabang sa gamhanan nini?
Ang UP nakahatag na 8% sa ekonomiya sa lungsod sa Nabunturan nga mukabat og 150 milyones ka pisos matag tuig. Apan ang problema nato mao ang bakukang nga karon midagsang nga sa atong kalubinaan. Mao nga gikinahanglan ang atong pagpakabana og pagpakiglambigit sa mga nagkalain-laing ahensya sa kagamhanan.
The rhinoceros beetle. It attacks both young and mature palms. The emerging triangular and geometric cut leaves are an unmistakable sign of the pest's attack. In mature palms, the beetle bores into the bud consisting of an open leaves, resulting in the scissor-trimmed appearance of the emerging leaves. Damaged palms show this tattered appearance and sometimes collapse of the youngest leaves. Repeated attacks often lead to death of the palm. The entry holes are often hidden by the leaf axils, but they can be recognized by the presence of chewed up fiber. These holes can become entry points for secondary attacks by the palm weevil and bud rot disease. In young palms, beetle attack results in twisted growth, often needing replanting. Under normal conditions, beetle population occurs at low levels. But when breeding sites are abundant, an outbreak is possible. In 1968, rhinoceros beetle caused damage valued at more than $1 million in South Pacific countries. It is mainly due to the abundance of the breeding sites after felling off coconut palms for replanting, change croppings, power line installations, land development, drought, and typhoons. What are these breeding sites? Decaying coconut logs, coconut stumps, sawdust heaps, farmyard manure, sugarcane trashes, stumps of rubber trees, farm trashes, rice straw and hull, cacao trunks and empty pods, and corn cobs, coconut crown.
In this decaying organic materials, beetles breed, lay their eggs, and complete the life cycle. Coconut crowns take only 3 months or less to decay and be suitable for egg laying. An undisposed coconut log or stump can support beetle breeding for 5 to 7 years. During outbreaks, direct damage accounts for 20 to 50% decrease in yield in 2 years and up to 75% in 3 years.
The beetle undergoes four development stages: the egg, larva, pupa, and finally the adult. Adult beetles complete their life cycle in an average of 171 days. The female lays about 70 to 130 eggs on decaying organic materials. It hatches in 7 to 18 days into larva. Feeding on the organic materials for 85 to 130 days and becoming a pupa, enclosed in a cocoon of soil and coconut fibers. The pupa will emerge as adult after 11 to 29 days in the breeding place. The adult is the destructive stage of the beetle. In 2 weeks to 1 month after emerging from its cocoon, the adult flies off to feed on the coconut crown. It lives for about 4 to 6 months, allowing more than one generation per year. The most practical and cheapest way for farmers to avert beetle outbreak is farm sanitation. Use the trunks as firewood, the debris or leaves as mulch, as practiced in Sri Lanka and India, and coconut sawdust as potting media, as practiced in the Philippines. Spread thinly piles of sawdust so they won't become breeding sites. Another way to prevent beetle damage is to inspect the young palms regularly. Adult beetles found in entry holes should be hooked with a metal 1 foot long. Using plants with insecticidal properties is also done. In India, for example, farmers chop a common weed species, Clerodendron infortunatum, into pieces of 10 to 15 centimeters, incorporated in the breeding sites. This weed kills the larvae of the rhinoceros beetle.
Farmers can also use naturally occurring green mascardine fungus, or GMF, and Oryctis virus. These are effective biological control agents. The spores of the green mascardine fungus germinate and multiply inside the body cavity of the beetle, resulting in death.
Soon, the fungus appears on the surface as a green mass. Apply GMF directly into the breeding sites that cannot be eliminated immediately, especially the coconut stumps, which usually remain after felling.
Like GMF, the Oryctis virus is naturally occurring. It is brought to the laboratory for multiplication to infect beetles through oral and swimming method in virus suspension.
The virus kills the beetle by multiplying inside the gut, resulting to its swelling and diarrhea, which is characterized by a white deposit at the abdominal tip as it dries up.
We can prevent beetle damage by using GMF in trap boxes in situations where there is massive felling of coconuts. In such situation, install the trap boxes within 3 months from felling. This allows us to trap the wild beetle population and prevent succeeding beetle generations to build up.
A hectare of land requires 5 trap boxes. A box will require 4 coconut log sections, each about 1 meter long. Fill the box initially with 8 centimeter layer of decaying coconut sawdust. On this layer, uniformly spread 25 grams of GMF. Add sawdust to the box, filling it to the rim while applying another 25 grams of GMF. Cover the trap box with coconut leaves to protect birds and fowls in the farm and to maintain moisture. Inspect the box as often as possible to check infectivity. Recharge the box with GMF and sawdust every 3 months. The beetles will lay their eggs in these boxes. Young larvae hatching from eggs are subsequently infected by GMF. There is another way of trapping the beetles. This is by attracting them into aggregation pheromone traps.
aggregation pheromone is an attractant. The trap consists of a polyvinyl chloride PVC pipe with a diameter of 10 centimeters. This pipe should be 5 feet long. Two PVC pipe traps are needed in a hectare. Install them in strategic places under shade. The bottom of the pipe sits on an empty can punched with holes at the bottom for drainage. Two windows are made on the pipe for entry of beetles. An aggregation pheromone sachet is hung inside the lower window of the pipe. Fill the pipe with 2 kilos of decaying coconut sawdust to provide the beetles natural habitat and prevent death by overcrowding, since they can be used later for rictus virus infection. Visit these traps once a week to check and collect the beetles. Pheromone is a good attractant. In the Philippines, 2,200 adult beetles were caught within 4 months, or an average of 500 beetles a month. Replenish the pheromones every 5 months and the sawdust when necessary. Collected adult beetles may be destroyed outright or infected with Oryctes virus for biological control. The beetles collected from pheromone traps shall be brought to the laboratory for virus infection. In the laboratory, virus suspension is prepared by macerating free-stored inoculum. The beetles are infected by swimming in this suspension for 10 minutes. Place the beetle in a plastic basin containing decaying sawdust and sugarcane as food for about 1 week. After 1 week, release the beetles at dusk to the beetle-damaged area. Release at least 10 virus-infected adults in 1 hectare. Beetles can also be released in decaying sawdust trap box during the day. They stay there until they fly off at night. Catch adult beetles to monitor the infection level. Check for presence of white excreta, which indicates virus infection. There are also 2 other ways of preventing beetle population buildup reported effective in India and Malaysia. The first is placing 12 grams of naphthalene balls in the axil of the spindle leaf, which farmers do every 45 to 60 days. The second is using oil cakes of neem, Asadiracta indica, or Marotti, Hydnocarpus wheatiana, in powder form. 250 grams of Marotti powder is mixed with equal volume of sand and applied at the base of the spindle leaf 3 times a year. In plantation, felled coconut logs and other debris may be buried in deep trenches. This eliminates all potential breeding sites. The cost may be high, but economical in the long run. Big companies in the Philippines practice this in crop conversion situations. Let's summarize the prevention and control measures against rhinoceros beetle. Farm sanitation. Regular inspection. Using plants with biopesticidal effect. Green muscardine fungus. Oryctes virus. Burying coconut logs, which are potential breeding sites. Applying naphthalene balls. Neem oil cakes. Roti powder.
Ang pakigbisog batok sa bakukaw. Sayang raman di ay. Apan kinahanglan nga kami mga maguma, maghugpong aron masanta ang mga pisting bakukang.